the previous video, we saw how to generate an ADT message and to send it to an HL7 server. However, we used the Happy Test Panel as a server, which didn't do anything with the received data. What we would like the server to do is to use the ADT message to generate a patient object and to insert the patient, if it doesn't exist yet, into the database. Then, once the patient is inserted, the server should send an ACK message back to the client to notify the success of the operation. If you want to know how to parse the information of the ADT message, you should look back at the client to see which segments are included in it. We had an MSH segment with a sending application and an incrementing sequence number. Then we had a PID segment where we filled in the patient name, the national number as internal ID, the date of birth, and the sex. How will the server handle the message? We created an HL7 server class in a new project. In the main, we first create a happy context. The context is responsible for the generation of the for the general configuration of happy and for handling the basic network operations. Next, we create a new server with the HL7 service class. The HL7 service class implements a runnable Java interface, which means that it can be started as a thread. This allows us to set up the basic server-side structure. The thread listens for events and dispatch calls to event handlers. Here, we have the ADT handler, and we register this handler as being responsible for managing incoming ADT A01 messages. Once we start the server, we'll have a thread running with the HL7 service and listening to port 1011. When an ADT A01 message is sent to that port, HL7 service will call a method in the ADT handler, which is called processMessage. This method returns an ACK message, which can be sent back by the HL7 service as a response to the ADT message. Let's now look at this ADT handler. We wanted to be able to insert patients into our database. Therefore, it will need to create instances of the Entity Manager factory, as well as the patient and person controllers. In the processMessage method, we first cast the incoming message in the ADT A01 class. We then create patient and person objects and fill in the information received from the ADT message. Once we have the person, we can use the controller to check if a person with this national number already exists. If that's not the case, we create the person and the patient in the database. Finally, we generate the ACK message. To get a person based on the national number, we use the method which we called findPersonByNationalNumber in the person GBA controller. This method uses named queries, which is a tool from our persistent system to quickly set up SQL queries. In the model class, person.java, we defined the SQL queries with a name to identify them and with some parameters in the queries, like in this case the national number. In the controller, we can create a named query and set the value of the parameter. With the getSingleResult method, we retrieve only one person for the given national number. If no result is found, there will be an exception. We catch that exception and return null. Let's look at this in action. We start with the HL7 server. When we run the server, we see that it prints a message in the terminal, then seemingly does nothing. We can see, however, that the program is still running. The HL7 service thread has been started and is waiting for incoming messages. Let's now open our client. We can fill in some test information in the field. We have to make sure to use the right port, 1011. Then we can click on the Send ADT button. You can see both in the client interface and in the terminal of the server that the HL7 transaction was successful. To be sure that the information was indeed entered into the database, we'll start our core application. There, we can see in the patient list that the new patient was created. Our information system is now capable of communicating with DICOM and HL7. In the next videos, we will add Fire for more modern web-based communication for patient data.